I never thought that I would be here today enjoying a project of this sort, of this type. As an alumni, that probably means the most, that we're the first to build a building of this type on my campus.
This project is critical at Georgia Tech because it's a building that represents the hub of sustainable activities on campus. And so for me, it's an amazing place to engage with students and faculty and staff who are interested in this topic, interested in learning more, and really seeing a home in the actions that we took throughout this building process.
Because we're trying to go for net positive energy, you really had to plant that flag and say, we're gonna do this. And we had to adjust all of our thinking to meet that energy budget, just like you try to meet a construction budget. We like to say that there was no decision that we made that didn't impact the energy budget. So if we pushed over here, we had to pull from there so that ultimately we could deliver this net positive building.
Well, one of the things that's most challenging is the water pedal in trying to get the harvesting of rainwater certified or permitted. But that process has been a challenge, obviously, for everybody because we're doing something new. The EPD folks, they brought their staff into the building for the start of that testing period, and they were as enthusiastic as we were. So they felt like they learned a lot in the process as well as we did.
This project was slated to be the first regenerative building, the first living building in the Southeast. And now that we're here, this project is going to serve as an example and a great precedent for all future projects to come. We can point to this building and show other clients, other institutions that this is possible.
I think an idea that doesn't get as much credit because it's hard to quantify when you're designing buildings like this or you're designing any kind of building is how important that connection to nature really is. This building, I think it really celebrates that aspect of building design. And so hopefully other people will look at that and see the value of those kinds of spaces.
The big thing that I'm taking away from this project that's really important is that I can't unlearn what I've learned, right? So now every time I go and I look at other buildings, this whole process runs through my head as I start to think about what other buildings are doing and how we can start to impact as many other buildings as we can to start to perform so much better and being inspired by the Kendeda Building to get us there.
It really is a living, breathing building, and we just don't do that every single day. I mean, a lot of things we do are automated and they're on timers and for other buildings. But this building actually thinks for itself and reacts to the environment.